the best lightweight shorts. So usually on my channel, I cover like heritage fashion, like sort of like vintage or vintage inspired stuff. And a lot of guys who like that kind of fashion refuse to ever wear shorts because men just didn't go outside their homes 100 years ago wearing shorts. But I am Australian, even though I live in New York City. And when summer weather kicks in, my Australian DNA like awakens and I just can't go without shorts. So if you're wearing shorts, make it count, make them high quality. And if you wait until the last possible second to stop wearing jeans and start wearing shorts, you probably want the lightest weight shorts you can get. So these ones are made with linen and hemp and really lightweight cotton. And there's also one pair with a bit of stretch in them. So this is a really good spread of the best sorts of materials and styles for lightweight shorts for summer. I want to thank Huckberry for providing most of these, by the way. Not all of them, but most of these are available at Huckberry's online store. They didn't sponsor this video or anything, but I did tell them I was making it and they said they'd send me some stuff to try out. Most of the stuff I didn't like and didn't put in, but some of it I did. So yeah, there you go, little disclosure. One last thing before I head in, I'm gonna show myself in these shorts. And while I'm not the strongest guy in the entire world, I should mention that I have an unusually large butt and thighs. So, you know, these probably won't look the same on you as they do on me. I look weird in a lot of shorts, but yeah, they're probably gonna be friendly on your body type than mine is what I'm trying to say. All right. So number one is Alex Crane's Bow Short. This is not a Huckberry one actually. I'm dropping this one in first because it's the only short I have that's 100% linen. Alex Crane sent these to me and this is an entire brand dedicated to lightweight fabrics or breezy clothes as they say on their site because quote, breeze is a spirit. It's a reminder to jump in the ocean and watch the clouds and hum a tune. So who could say no to that, right? Well, I mean, you might at $75 for a pair of shorts, but their supply chain is like, it's very cool. The linen, which comes from flax, is grown in a farming co-op in Normandy, France. And the fibers are separated by a process called dew retting, which means they basically let the sun and rain do it throughout the month of August. And the fibers are spun into yarn and woven into fabric in a facility in India that uses 80% carbon neutral electricity. The place they're made is like actually certified with a whole bunch of working conditions organizations like SA800. Anyway, they're well-made, ethical clothing. And although linen is sometimes thought of as a bit rough and itchy, I mean, it often is rough and itchy, they wash it with biodegradable enzymes so it's soft from the get-go and you don't have to wear it a bunch of times first for it to soften for you. They also come in a dozen colors, like a really wide range. These ones here are the pine color you often see in their advertising. And yeah, they also have linen shirts and pants and even jackets if you want to check that out. So it's a cool company, cool fabric, simple design, no logos or anything. Just note that you need to size up. My waist is 32 inches. I usually get a medium, but these are a large, so keep that in mind. Number two is Taylor Stitch's Après shorts. This one's a bit longer at 8 inches on the inseam. And this is actually not linen, it's 6 ounce hemp, which is very durable. Most sources say it's 8 times stronger than linen, and it's like one of the most eco-friendly fibers out there. An average yield gets you almost twice as much material as linen. It does need more water and nutrients than linen though, but it still takes like half as much water as cotton. And it also grows much faster and makes more fiber than cotton does. So anyway, hemp, it's great. It's a, you know, pretty eco-friendly. It's very antibacterial, so it won't stink so much during summer adventures. And it's very breathable in that it doesn't hold a lot of moisture. That's like what it means when people say it's breathable. It doesn't hold lots of moisture. So it's really good for summer shorts. It was probably dumb to include it on this list because it's almost sold out, but it's super comfy. It's a pretty loose, easygoing fit as well, even on me. It's got buttons through the back pockets to keep your stuff secure. And it's worth getting if they're not sold out. If they are, sorry to tell you how great these shorts are. Number three is Rhythm's Classic Linen Jam. Rhythm with a period is an Australian brand, so I should probably say Rhythm with a full stop because we don't say period in Australia. It's a bad name, but they've managed to expand a bit into the American market with their classic beachy vibes. This is their classic linen jam, inspired, so they say, by timeless design, whatever that means. But they're really nice. I keep criticizing them. I really like these shorts. They're super lightweight and they're also very breathable because they're mostly linen. It's 55% linen, 45% cotton. I got mine in this pretty sexy black, but there are a few other colors out there, including a beachier sand color. It's made with an adjustable cord, which I prefer for shorts, you might have noticed, because my butt gets significantly bigger and smaller throughout the year based on how often I can be bothered to lift weights. So anyway, I like the expandable waistline for shorts personally, but the next one doesn't, so keep an eye out. Weirdly, they don't advertise the inseam, they advertise the outseam on these shorts, which is 17 inches, but I measured these, the inseam is 7 inches, and they cost $50, which is pretty reasonable for something of this quality, but it makes sense given they're made in China. I don't like this logo here personally, but as soon as I'm done filming this, I'm gonna get an X-Acto knife and cut the threads to it to make them nice and simple. I'm gonna do the same with this pocket on the back. But yeah, you can simplify these if you want to, and I like them a lot. Next up is Flint and Tinder's 365 short, $64. This is Flint and Tinder's flagship short. It's gotten 100 reviews, and it's available in 7 and 9 inch inseams, which is really cool, and 7 colors. And unlike the other options on this list, it's also cut like a chino, so you've got a fly and button and belt loops for a more dressed up feel. Now it's worth noting that this isn't made with linen or hemp or anything. It's 8 ounces per square yard of 98% cotton and 2% spandex. That 2% is why I'm including it, because that stretch is what sells it for a lot of guys as a short that looks pretty smart when you're out and about, but also makes it comfy for lying around the house or a pool party or what have you. They cost $64, and you get a $20 discount if you get 2 pairs of them, at the moment anyway. And they're made in Indonesia, in a sustainable factory where they recycle and repurpose 98% of the water used, which is a nice touch. So yeah, these are probably the best dressy shorts on this list. And the last one to mention is the Wellen Easy Chino Short, 8-inch inseam. This is the one I've been wearing the most this summer, largely because it's my only blue pair of shorts. But I really dig that the material is 68% cotton and 32% linen. So it's very breathable, but also very robust. And Wellen is one of these companies that emphasizes sustainability, so the cotton is organic, which actually does matter because it produces like half as much CO2 as regular cotton, less water and no pesticides and all that good stuff. I wore these when I was reporting at the World's Strongest Man this year. The only thing I might change about these is I make the drawstring the same color as the rest of the shorts, which is what Taylor Stitch does here. I prefer it when that happens because then, like, you know, the drawstring doesn't stand out as much. If you happen to have bought a shirt that's a bit too short for you, which I often do because I have a weirdly long torso, then these wouldn't stand out as much. They're also fairly tight. I got a medium and my butt looks really big in these, so if that's a concern for you, you might want to size up. In the reviews that I read of theirs, a lot of people said that they had to size up for these shorts. So that's an idea for you. But the general consensus is they have more room in the thighs and butt than a lot of shorts out there. So they might be a good pick for, you know, athletic guys or bigger thighed guys. If I could do it again, I think I'd get a large for me actually, but I like them a lot. You get the lightness of linen and the softness of cotton and the eco-friendly hit of organic cotton. So yeah, I like these ones a lot, I wear them a lot. All right, those are my picks for the best lightweight shorts. Yeah, man, I had the best linen, best hemp, best blend, best dressy ones. Pretty good list, pretty happy with these shorts. Let me know in the comments what your favorite lightweight shorts are, especially if you've got some favorite hemp shorts, cause like 100% hemp shorts are pretty hard to find. I'm just kind of curious about that one. And make sure you subscribe as well, cause I got a lot more videos about good quality clothing and classic materials for guys who like to look good.